Greetings once again. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. The gays for stays no malls by Binan, Strasvice, Nihal Ma. My talk focuses on today Nikola trucking RIP or rest in peace? Question mark. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. And now that we've had a chance to take a look at the general performance specs for the Model 3 and the 2170 battery that drives it, those numbers are really interesting because they kind of suggest what the capability of the battery is in terms of the performance that it can deliver to both cars and trucks. After everyone started doing the numbers with the 18650 battery as a solution, there was sort of no way that a truck with a class 8 ranking of 80,000 pounds could really make a long distance run with of any more than 300 miles in the previous iteration. But now that we're switching batteries, it becomes more obvious why Elon Musk was reluctant to embrace the whole concept of a range extender with hydrogen, as is the case with Nikola. Obviously, he knew what the battery could and would do, and therefore was planning this a while ago. So I believe that an interesting challenge pops up. If you look at the specs on the Nikola truck, there's a situation there where that vehicle is expected to go, from what I read, as far as 1,200 miles on a combination of a lithium-ion battery with hydrogen. Those numbers look terrific, and it looked terrific against a Tesla possible distance of 300 miles. But now that Tesla's switched gears into the 2170, you now have a situation where you're facing Tesla competition for the Nikola truck, where the Tesla truck is a 500 to 700 mile truck, and that distance is about perfect for when truckers are required to take breaks anyway. And there are all these other side variables, like, for example, if you have a truck and it's fully loaded with fuel, that weight of the fuel might put it over its weight limit. So there are reasons why people may choose not to do the full complement of fuel anyway. So really, that 500 mile distance in my mind is about the same length of distance, you know, equivalent to a car, let's say, going 200 miles, which eliminates most of the range anxiety that people might have. The other problem that runs there for the Nikola is the fact that hydrogen requires new infrastructure and placement so that vehicles can refuel at them. Nikola has displayed a network of service providers that will provide this solution. But the challenge is that, number one, you've got to manufacture the fuel, and number two, you've got to get it to the locations where it'll be used by large trucks. The challenge here is that you're adding a cost layer that to the whole process, whereas most folks, a supercharger for a truck does cost money, but there's actually somewhat of a network of superchargers out there already that's working well, and it doesn't require you to move large amounts of fuel or any other asset. So the general theory is that if in fact you have to get fuel to your Nikola or to your Tesla facility, you can just do it through the electric grid, whereas with Nikola, you have an additional layer of costs that is related to the movement and storage of the hydrogen it takes to make that system work. So the problem that pops up is that how do you handle all the costs associated with this? And once you're done paying for those costs, does it make it competitive with a battery-only solution from Tesla? And I think that the Nikola solution is that it costs disadvantage to a battery-only solution from Tesla, A, and then B, you have the other challenge of ongoing, you know, variable costs related to movement of that hydrogen around, et cetera. So I just think that by the time you look at the additional costs related to enlisting the capabilities of a Nikola truck, while it's attractive and it's good for the environment, I just think that the total of the Tesla solution becomes a better one. The one lane that is open to them is that when you get into super cold or super hot environments, you know, the battery conditioning process that the electric cells have to go through, et cetera, may result in an opportunity there for Nikola. So for example, if you have a very cold area, if the range of the battery from a Tesla drops by 100 or 200 miles, you then now have an environment where it might be a better environment to run a hydrogen solution. So there may be niches where it's still viable, but the question is, are there enough niches that they can sort of hide in that are protected from the onslaught of the Tesla solution? And the landscape was wide open before Tesla delivered the 2170 battery and the range its trucks will have with it. But I think that landscape has gotten a lot narrower, and the question is it worth putting in hundreds of millions of dollars of investment when sort of the open lane that you had to be successful keeps shrinking every day with new solutions like Tesla at long range on a 2170 battery? So unfortunately, my assessment of it is that the market potential starts to become too small to make it worth the cost of the Nikola build-out. And I think unless they can find something brilliant and new, this whole effort may have just hit a giant brick wall called Tesla and Elon Musk. I think it's unfortunate because those folks did a lot of good work, and I think it's an attractive product. It's just that I don't see it working. But I look forward to the comments from my viewers, and this is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Please like and subscribe. Tschüss, mach's gut. Au revoir, à tout à l'heure. Have a great day. Thanks for now.